Hi, I'm Jeff Goldthorpe, and most people have experienced that one or two times or three times in their life, experience in May, when they are calling their mother and they get a busy signal, and it's a special kind of busy signal. It means that the circuits are busy between your phone and your mother's phone. That also happens in other kinds of circuits when people are in emergencies and they're dialing 911. The 911 call centers that are on the other ends of the other end of those calls can also be busy, and that can happen if there's not enough circuits that are serving the 911 call center, and those circuits are set up in advance. So there's a limited number of them. They're set up for a local area, and all emergencies are local. Even a traffic accident is a local emergency. And you can imagine what would happen in a big highway if there was a huge accident that would involve a tanker truck and, you know, and any number of cars, that everybody suddenly calls the 911 call center. And if that call center is limited in the number of circuits that it has serving it, then some people are going to get busy signals. And it may not just be people that are on the highway, it could be people that are having other kinds of emergencies. So this can be a problem, and it's a problem that comes up frequently, or not frequently, but it comes up mostly with today's technology and occasions like the ones that I was just mentioning, where you've got a lot of traffic surging on a small area, like a 911 call center. In the years that have elapsed, the last few years, we've seen the emergence of the internet as a platform, a technology that people are using more and more. And then the use of IP-based technologies for critical communications. And that applies to 911 as well. And one of the things we're seeing with next-generation 911 is a technology that would allow calls that are destined for a particular 911 call center to be routed in a more dynamic way, just like traffic is routed on the Internet today. The Internet was originally designed for dynamic routing, so that if there were some sort of a outage in the network, if a switch was out or a router was out, traffic could be routed around that outage dynamically. Well, a similar kind of situation here. If you have a particular 911 call center that has a larger than expected amount of traffic that is headed in its direction for some reason, in a IP-based world, that PSAP could be configured in such a way that the traffic could be diverted automatically to an alternate PSAP, and there'd be no need for any kind of coordination that can take some time to do backup, to send traffic to backup PSAPs today. That happens today, but it just might take a little bit longer. In a next generation 911 world, that can happen much quicker. So that's one of the many reasons why next generation 911 is a desirable path to be on. Something that that 911 call centers ought to be planning for. There are a lot of implications with next generation 911 deployment. They include financial implications. There's governance implications, operational implications, and technological implications. So there's a lot of aspects to this that have to be considered. One of the organizations that PSAT or 911 call centers might want to consider referring to when they're in the middle of that planning is the National Emergency Number Association, NENA, and so I would encourage you to look at what NENA has to offer there. They've got a lot of thinking in collaboration with the industry in that space. So with that, I would encourage you to look into it. Next generation 911 is coming, and probably the sooner the better. So thank you, and have a good day.